Hey guys, how are you? I believe all of you are very great, doing great in your home. So let us start our new chapter, that is chapter number 2, work power energy. Before going to details about the work power energy, let us start this chapter with a very positive note. What is that? In the face of doubt, take action anyway. So guys, I know this is the crucial time and all of we are sitting in our home. So what you do, you must go through all the video very sincerely and honestly. And if you have any doubt, please let me know about in the comment box. I'll let you clarify your doubt. So let us start with work. The first topic is what work. So guys, you know, you have used this work many a times while, you know, sitting on the sofa, watching television, then surfing social media. And if somebody asking you what are you doing, then you said or you replied that I'm doing my work. Yes or no? But work in physics is used in very specific manner, guys. Okay, so let us discuss what exactly the work is. So the formula for work is equal to F into S. Yes or no? F into S. So where F is applied force and S is what? Displacement. So guys, you remember one thing: if you apply a force and the body is displaced by some amount, then only the work is to be done. Otherwise, not. So for example, suppose this is a wall, and if you apply a force here, if the wall, will it move? Provided you are a Thor or something like Krish or like that character. Huh? Just kidding, guys. So if you are applying a force on a wall, the wall doesn't move. It means what? There is no work. You have not performed any work because there is no displacement. Yes or no? So work is what? The dot. You can see here the dot. Dot product of two vectors. You can find here force is a vector and displacement also is a vector. So if I expand this, I'll find F, magnitude of F into S, or magnitude of what? Displacement into cos theta. I think you have gone through scalar vector in your class 9. Yes or no, guys? Yes or no? So W is equal to Fs into cos theta. So in the work depends upon two factors. One is force, one is displacement. As I have said already in this example, by application of force to a wall does not move implies there is no work. Yes or no? Now, what is the unit of work, guys? The unit of work, W is equal to F into S. F is for Newton and for the displacement, this is meter. So, SI unit of work is what? Newton meter, which is also known as joule. Yes or no? And what is CGS unit? The CGS unit of force is what? Dyne and displacement is what? Centimeter. So dyne into centimeter is what known as erg, ERG, guys. Yes or no? So let us convert the unit from MKS to CGS. So I can write 1 Newton meter is equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne. Yes or no, guys? 1 Newton equal to 10 to the power 5 dyne into 10 square centimeter, 1 meter is equal to. So 1 Newton meter is equal to 10 to the power 7 dyne into centimeter. Yes or no? So I can say 1 joule is equal to 10 to the power 7 erg. Yes or no, guys? So many a time this question must ask to convert the SI unit of work into the CGS unit. Now let us discuss about the different types of work. You know, since there is a theta, which is angle between F and or S, so theta could be 0, could be positive, could be negative. Yes or no? So first case, I can consider case 1. So case 1, now this is a body. If I by the application of force, if the body displaces in the same direction, I can say force and displacement are in the same direction, then I can say the angle theta equal to 0. So W is equal to Fs cos theta. So theta 0 means what? Theta 0 means what? Cos theta equal to 1. As I know the cos 0 is equal to 1. So W is what? I can say positive. Yes or no, guys? Yes or no? For example, I can take if in a free fall of a body of mass m under the gravity, a height under gravity through a height h, I can say small height, height h from A to B, just like this. This is what a body, it is free fall from a height h. This is the body of mass m. Then I can say the force is towards the what? Gravitational force and direction, or I can say displacement is also towards the same direction. Yes or no? So I can say both are in same direction, hence the work done is what? Positive. Yes or no? I can say theta is equal to 0. Yes or no, guys? Second thing is what? Second thing, theta is equal to, I can say 90. Yes or no? This is possible only when the force and displacement are in the perpendicular to each other. Yes or no? So theta equal to 90, and what is cos 90 equal to 0? So work done is 0. I can take the example of a coolie. If a coolie have some weight, now this is a coolie suppose, and this is moving in this direction. So you can find the weight. This is the weight. The force is in the gravitational force in downward. But it is, since this is moving in the this direction, so the angle between the displacement and force is what, 90 degree, and hence the cos 90 equal to 0. Yes or no? I can take another example. You can say, now this is what, earth is moving around sun. So this is what the direction of force, yes or no, which is a centripetal force, which we already have discussed in the centripetal or centrifugal forces. Yes or no? So this is what the direction of force, but this is what the what direction of displacement. So I can say the angle between the two is what, 90 degree, and hence the angle, the work done is equal to 0. Yes or no? And the last one is what? When theta is equal to 90 degree, this will be possible only when the force, suppose the force and displacement are in what, opposite direction to each other. Yes or no? So I can say, take the example, when a body moves on a surface, the force of friction between the body and the surface is in the direction opposite to the motion. That is, theta is equal to 90 degree. I can say, suppose guys, if we here a body fall from a height h. Now let us throw a body from ground to this height. Okay, so this is a body of mass m. As you can see, the force is the gravitational force. It is downward, but the motion or displacement is upward. So angle between the two is 180 degree, and hence the work done is what, negative. Yes or no, guys? So this is what the brief explanation of work. Now moving to the next is what, power. So power. One thing I forgot to tell you guys, in the last chapter you have studied the moment of force. So in moment of force also, Newton into meter, remember, if you remember, force into displacement, yes or no? Force into distance. So as you can say, distance is a scalar quantity. So scalar quantity multiplied to any vector is a vector. That's why moment of force is a vector, whereas the work done is a scalar, which I already have discussed while I was teaching you the moment of force. Yes or no? Now let us move towards the power. What is power? So power is nothing but work per time. Yes or no? Work done per time is what? Known as power. Very simple. I can say, all of you, I mean you might have bought a bulb. Yes or no? Electric bulb. So, what you say while buying a bulb? You ask shopkeeper, give me the 100 watt or 60 watt bulb. Yes or no? So the unit of power is what? Watt, W-A-T-T, which is nothing but joule per second. So what is the meaning of power? Now in 1 second, what is the work that is to be done? Yes or no, is what the power. So this is what the definition of power, guys, or I can say the unit of power is what? Watt, W-A-T-T, and one more power is what? HP, horsepower. So you know, 1 HP is equal to 746 watt. This is the conversion, guys. You need to remember, this will help you while solving the problems. Yes or no? So I already have discussed the work and then power. Power is very small. Yes or no? Now let us discuss about the difference between the work and power. Okay, this is work and this is power. What is the difference? So work done by a force is equal to the product of force and displacement. Yes or no? And power is equal to what? Work done by per second. The second thing is what? Work done does not depend upon time. This work done does not depend upon time. As you can see here, power depends upon the value of time. Here the SI unit is joule, but here is the SI unit is what? Watt, W-A-T-T, watt. Okay. Now moving to energy. So a body capable, now this is energy. We study energy. Okay, so let us discuss about energy. A body capable of doing work is said to possess energy. The energy possessed by a body is measured by the amount of work done or work that the body can perform. When a body does work, its energy decreases. While if work is done on the body, its energy increases. It means that whenever work is done, there is always transfer of energy. Thus, energy and work done are related to each other. We can say energy of a body is its capacity of do work. Okay, capacity of doing work is what known as energy, guys. Remember, capacity of doing work is known as energy. Okay, so the unit of energy, I can say SI unit of energy, first is SI unit of energy. So the SI unit of energy is joule, and the CJ unit is same thing. Energy is same as work, I can say. Okay. So even the bigger unit of energy, I can say kilowatt hour. Okay, this is kilowatt multiplied with time is what? Kilowatt hour and watt hour, I can say. Okay, or one thing is what I can say, electron volt, electrical energy, electron volt is also the energy of, or sorry, the unit of energy. One electron volt, I can say, one electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. You should remember this. Okay, now let us discuss about the energy and power difference. This is power. So energy is first, energy of a body is its capacity to do work, but power of a source is the rate of which energy supplied by it. Yes or no? Second is, energy spent does not depends on time, guys, but the power depends upon time. Here is the unit is joule, here is the unit is watt. Okay, so I believe this video will help you to understand a little bit about the work, power and energy. Thank you.